They all
rip. Rip. Oof. That was almost a triple.
Did he grenade all three of us?
Not so much. I got one. But there's still three out of that four coming.
More.
Don't do it, young blood. I got two. I got three.
One more.
Yes, I got four. Oh my god. Spilled orange juice all over my room, but I got her.
Hit B.
The quadra kill.
This haunted house sucks.
Things just got a whole lot spookier.
So I couldn't go another day without making another Battle Royale video because over the past month since I uploaded the last one, everything feels different. Duos are a thing now. Squads are a thing now. We've got skeletons and ghouls.
Will you stop that? Nobody likes that sound effect. What is this, Johnny Test?
Do you ever get pissed off when people ask you about your name? They're like, Muffin Puncher, what's that all about? It's like, I punch muffins, man. Leave me alone.
I got
you need an explanation.
Muffin Puncher, and then I have another account called Cupcake Puncher.
I'll get to everything in due time, but let me start from the beginning. Number one, that video entirely contained footage of Battle Royale when it was not yet free to play, and the weapons were significantly less accurate. So things were much more spray and pray before the free to play patch. Number two, I received a ton of tweets, emails, and comments about saying, you can kill 99 people in this game and still lose. Most of you got it, but plenty of you couldn't figure it out. So here goes. You can kill 98 enemies, then accidentally kill yourself, which makes 99, and as the last guy was just hiding in a bush, he could easily win the game. So there you go. Apparently some of you are not a fan of math, riddles, or the Riddler. Or you just don't think about killing yourself on an ongoing basis. That's probably a good thing. And number three.
Oh my god, is this hilarious!
In case you haven't heard yet, Epic is cracking down on hackers like you saw in the last video by quite literally suing them, which I think is hysterical. All that I can picture is these hackers bragging about stream sniping Twitch streamers while saying, what are you gonna do, sue me? And then Epic Games is like... Bet. Yeah. We're definitely gonna sue you, which is pretty damn spooky. I think that shows what I'm truly scared of this time of year. Like, a clown could climb out of my fridge right now with a chainsaw and I wouldn't care. It would mean nothing to me. But if a bunch of lawyers kindly knocked on my door with an envelope in their hands asking about a lawsuit, I would be petrified. I wouldn't know what to do. I would jump off my balcony and aim for something sharp. I can't deal with that. And with that being said, they are banning scores of people in an effort to keep the game clean. Like, the entire skydive down from the party bus is basically just a kill feed of people getting smashed with a ban hammer.
Oh god, Flat Baby 46. That's such an unfortunate name to have when you're struck with a ban hammer.
But even with these efforts by Epic, you still get killed by a hacker every now and again. Like just yesterday, I was murdered by Harry Potter.
Okay, we got a pump shotty, which I'm not gonna call Lil Pump. I know I said that previously, but listening to Gucci Gang makes me want to jump off a bridge, so I will not call the pump shotty Lil Pump. And how did he how? Oh, okay, I get it. I was like, how did Harry Potter get six or eight kills in 5 seconds? Oh, it's because he's hacking. At least give him some credit. Give him some kind of credit because he's not trying to cover it up. He's not trying to play it off. He is unabashedly just killing people that he can't even see with an invisible gun right now. So I ain't even mad. I'm just interested to see what he does. Oh my God.
With this new Halloween update, they've added cosmetics like skeleton outfits for your character and even a scythe skin for your pickaxe. And all I have to say is, since when is a female ghoul worth more than a male skeleton? Hashtag bone lives matter. And you better believe that the first thing that I did when things got spooky is cut somebody in half like I was the Grim Reaper, because you deserve to die if you bring a gun to a scythe fight.
This is gonna be tight. If he beats me to this gun on this balcony, I'm boned. I'm completely boned. But if I can take it away from him, I can definitely 1v1 him with a scythe. Let's see.
Fight!
Oh, I got the bullets! Ah, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only got four more. There's two.
Finish him!
Come on, man, give me that! Yes, I got him! Oh, God!
I've also started playing the game with much less of a hide-and-seek style and much more of a monster truck rally mentality, and that I try to pack as much action in the first 5 minutes as I possibly can.
First blood!
motherfucker today!
Your skill level drastically increases if you shoot for the insanely chaotic and heavily populated areas, because that early game panic teaches you exactly how to survive in all types of engagements and is the real secret to get good. I especially love how terrifying those first 30 seconds are when you can't find weapons and you're running around like a madman, but all you can find is ammo.
What am I supposed to do with these?
That's always my favorite, Canadian, is when you land and all you're finding is bullets. Like, well, what am I supposed to do with these? I don't have a gun. What do you want me to do with these?
Throw them at light speed.
And then, of course, somebody comes around the corner with, like, a big-ass shotgun. You're just like, oh, thank you. I'm gonna throw some rounds at your face before I die.
I farmed all these rounds for you. You can take these.
No, but I will admit, Walrus, the most clever one that I've seen today is a dude opened up a door so he could let me in. Through all of his grenades, I came in, he shut the door, and we both died. I was like, damn.
I can hear her. There she is.
Get back here. There's no running away. You'll only die tired.
Where did she?
Oh, shit, crap.
A spot that I love is the prison just beside Moisey Meyer, because not only is it filled with stellar loot, but if you can't find anybody, you can always run around shutting doors in the face of anybody that chases you. It's perfect.
I could probably survive this if she's a bad player. Just shutting doors in her face like that one. There's one door and another door. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Another door. Do I see it? Another door. Oh shit, she's still here.
I think it's obvious at this point that I absolutely adore the shotguns now, and I'm not sure if it was the free-to-play patch that changed the spread, or just that I've learned exactly how to use them, and that they're confetti beyond 10 meters, but inside 10 meters, oh baby, are they scary.
The flanks, the flanks! I guess that's much less of a flank and much more to people that are just super preoccupied with killing each other that don't even notice the person sneaking up, but whatever. Easiest double kill ever. Whoa, hold on. Ask for our special sauce. Made with unknown substances. What is... I've seen Harold and Kumar before. And why is an ice cream $8 and a burger $30? This is worse than Rainbow Six Vegas 2.
$10 for some hot dogs. They're like three of the same panini and they're all different prices. Why even drink $9?
Sandini's paninis.
Why would you pay $2.75 for... Why is chili more expensive than a burrito? It's $2.75 for a taco.
That's outrageous. Immersion ruined.
But if you really want guaranteed legendary items, you've got to go for the recently added supply drop. You'll hear it like a whistle in the direction that it spawns, with a flare in the landing spot and a balloon slowly falling to the ground with all kinds of legendary tier loot on the inside.
You know what? I hate to give up one of my three shotties, because you know I love my shotties, but I guess I'll give it up for this legendary sniper. I guess.
Just be aware that this is a high-risk, high-reward maneuver, because players love to bait out these supply crates and murder you immediately after picking up the loot, so be careful.
Please no. Oh, I hit him. Oh, baited. Baited.
And it seems as if the new key to victory nowadays is the RPG, given how skilled players are at constructing cover now, especially in squads. So hogging the rocket launcher is highly recommended.
I'm gonna take it down. Say goodbye to your wall, homeboy. Oh god, I'm gonna die here. Oh, nice! Thank
Are you serious?
God, that was close. This is so much loot. Please get over here. Hang on, I'm almost there.
Up your flank.
Are you kidding me? He's hit for 50, what? I hit him.
Okay, I got her,
nice.
I got her.
There's your win, boys.
You hit him right in the feet with that rocket launcher.
I know, but I was like, oh, she should have died. Maybe I should have used a shotgun, I don't know. At least we got it.
However, I will say that it's not perfect for close quarters, because even though it fires spoopy pumpkins after the Fort Nightmares update, somebody with full armor and a shotgun is probably still gonna curb stomp you in a 1v1.
Come here, guy, come here. That's a solid. Well, it's no Carl Gustav, I'll tell you that.
On that topic, I still find it hilarious how often I can win engagements where I'm severely outgunned if I rely on accuracy. I'm not saying that you can always outskill somebody waving a shotgun in your face, but never underestimate somebody that's accurate with a revolver.
It's hand.
hey, when all else fails, just spam frag grenades at the guy and rush him with a shotty. It works every time. Kind of.
And a one, and a two, and a three frags. If he doesn't die to this, I swear. Easy. That almost didn't work, but it somehow did.
And that's about it. I would like to thank you very much for watching, even though I'm sick as fuck. And be sure to tune in next time when I stop buying Elsa brand Kleenex.
Change the one that always changed.